So good evening to all of you. We are doing chapter number 7 and 8 today. Starting with the first concept of chapter number 7, that is vinegar production. We know that vinegar is used in each country and it is for very different purposes. But the basic one is to give sour taste to our food materials. Vinegar kahan kahan par use hota hai? So it is used in preservation of pickles, that is achar, or in sauces, ketchups, chutneys, etc. Chemically speaking, vinegar is 4% acetic acid. I repeat, vinegar is 4% acetic acid. CH3COOH. So try and remember. The basic things that are required for production of vinegar is anything that is sweet, contains sugar, like fruit juices, maple syrup, starch of the roots, sugar molasses, etc. All of these are going to be fermented with the help of fungus Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is yeast. After fermentation, what we get is ethanol. Now this ethanol is further broken down by Acetobacter and Glucanobacter, which will give rise to acetic acid and its byproducts. Basically, they will be separated. Further, by rarefaction, that is lessening the density, you can split acetic acid and the byproducts. Okay. Now we take acetic acid. We put a bleaching agent called potassium ferrocyanide, which gives it the pure white, or you can say the transparent color that vinegar has. After pasteurization, that is alternate heating and cooling, if there is any microbe left, that microbe is going to get destroyed. And then passing sulfur dioxide gas through acetic acid, what you get is vinegar. So I hope you have understood. So the organic acids that are used, organic acids and the microbes that are useful for producing them, let's try and understand. Sabse pehla source, the sugar and beet molasses along with ammonia salt. Which microbe is used for breaking them down? So Brevibacterium and Corynebacterium. The amino acid that is produced is L-glutamic acid, which is used for production of monosodium glutamate. So you have to remember, L-glutamic acid aya, to glutamate hai, monosodium glutamate, MSG, also called as Ajinomoto. Next, we have sugar molasses and salt. Aspergillus niger, whatever you want to pronounce, you can. Produces citric acid. Where is it used? So it is used in cold drinks, it is used in toffees, it is used in chocolate production, etc. Third, glucose and cornstarch liquor. Again, aspergillus niger. Gluconic acid is produced and this is used for production of supplements of calcium and iron. Basically, mineral multivitamins and mineral tablets that you eat have this gluconic acid present in them. Then again, molasses and cornstarch liquor as the source. Microbe used is Lactobacillus delbrueckii. Amino acid that you get is lactic acid. Ye to hume yogurt production mein yaad ho jana chahiye. Lactobacillus delbrueckii produces lactic acid. It is used as a source of nitrogen and it is also used for production of multivitamins. Molasses and cornstarch liquor, Aspergillus itaconius gives us itaconic acid, which is used in paper, textile, plastic industry, gum production, etc. Okay. Yes, sugar molasses are basically the fermented residue of sugarcane. Then we do a small concept of xanthan gum. All of these have this thick density because of xanthan gum, which is produced with the help of starch and molasses, fermented with the help of Xanthomonas species to give us xanthan gum. Soluble both in hot as well as cold water, and it gives high density. It is used for production of pigments, fertilizers, weedicides, textile pigments, toothpastes, high quality paper, etc. Now we come to the second table of the page. Very, very important. Food materials like cold drinks, ice cream, all of these basically. Do you think they have actual colors and actual flavors? Are these derived actually from fruits? Not all of them. Okay. So there are specific food colors, essences, which are obtained by microbial processing. Especially in the lockdown phase when many people were baking, you must have come across many food essences. The most common one is vanilla essence. Okay. So all of this is produced with the help of microbes. So let's look at the substances which are obtained by microbial processing and their roles. Essence is the smell. Okay. 70%, 60 to 70% of the taste that you have is because of the smell of the food. Okay. And flavor is the taste. So when we talk about citric acid, malic acid, and lactic acid, these are substances which are produced by microbial processing. And what is their function in the food? So they give us acidity. Okay, so they impart acidity into foodstuffs. Basically, when we talk about pickles, okay, lemon is used more. Why? So that the pickle inside it does not go stale. Acidic agar ho gaya, uska matlab wahan par microbes ka growth hone ka chances kam. So it can be used as a preservative. Then we have glutamic acid, lysine, and tryptophan, which are protein binders. Now see, students, you must have heard that we can eat a lot of protein, but not all of it is going to bind with your muscles. Basically, not all of them is going to result in muscle building. So you must have seen people taking these protein supplements, especially while working out, and therefore enabling them to have a good physique or a good build. So these are going to have glutamic acid, lysine, and tryptophan, which are protein binders. Basically, this enables the protein that you eat attaching or joining or binding with your muscles, therefore leading to muscle growth. Niacin and natamycin are microbial restrictors. Jaise humne catalyst suna hai, jo reaction ko speed up karta hai. Yahan par ye microbial resistors hai. Basically, they stop the microbial growth. Then we have ascorbic acid, also called as vitamin C, vitamin B12 and B2, which are obviously vitamins and antioxidants. Antioxidants are very, very useful for your body to remain active. You must have heard about this fact that if you eat apples during the night, they are going to be more effective than a cup of coffee. Why? Because it is very, very high in antioxidants, which activates your brain. Then you have beta carotene, lycopene, xanthine, and lutein. All of these are edible colors. Polysaccharides and glycolipids are emulsifiers, basically for substances which have to be exported or imported from a long distance. Wo kharab na ho, isiliye unme hote hain emulsifiers. Vanillin, ethyl butyrate, peppermint, essence of various fruits and flowers, all of these are essence, basically giving them that smell. Xylitol and aspartame are artificial sweeteners. Just like stevia leaves, jisse sugar free banta hai, waise hi xylitol aspartame bhi artificial sweeteners hain. So I hope you people have understood this chart as well now. Let's talk about the landfilling sites now. All the degradable waste, that is the one which can be decomposed with the help of microbes, is accumulated in the urban areas, and that is used for the purpose of landfill sites. Open spaces are selected, provided they are away from the cities. Okay, that is away from the residential area. Large pits are going to be dug. These pits are going to be lined with plastic sheets. Now, why plastic sheets? Because jo bhi toxic substances yahan par breakdown hoga, wo directly aaspaas ke soil ko hum nahi karna chahiye. So this is going to be as a precaution against pollution of soil. Why? Because this can lead to leaching, that is basically entering of harmful chemicals into the soil. Then the compressed waste is going to be dumped into the pit, and it is going to be covered with layers of soil, layers of sawdust, then there are going to be leafy wastes, and in the end specific biochemicals. Now biochemicals can be enzymes, biochemicals can be different types of microbes, which are going to speed up the reaction of the overall degradation or decomposition. Bioreactors are also mixed at certain places where you can control the speed of decomposition overall. And it can also enhance the entire microbial process by addition of either water or air. Microbes that are present in the top layers will decompose the waste. This completely filled pit is going to be sealed with soil slurry so that a new pit can be formed above it, so as to have a multi-layered landfill site. No, there is not going to be an additional plastic layer on the up. It is only in the sidelines of the pit. After the decomposition, what we get is best quality of compost. And the most important thing is that these landfill sites can be reused. Okay, so you put one entire lot, it gets decomposed, you get good quality compost or fertilizer, you can take it out and you can use these sites back. Now we talk about sewage management overall, clean technology pura continue kar lete hain. So in villages, domestic sewage is directly disposed of either in the nearby soil or in a biogas plant. But in cities, what happens is these are taken to microbial processing units. Microbes are mixed with the sewage that decompose any compounds which can give us diseases like cholera, typhoid, etc. Okay, so jo bhi harmful microbes hain, basically unko kill kar diya jata hai using our useful microbes. When decomposition reaction is happening, they release methane and carbon dioxide gas. And there are some substances which are unusual to be found in the waste. Such chemicals are called as xenobiotics. So there are special type of bacteria called phenol oxidizing bacteria, which are going to break down these xenobiotic chemicals. The sludge that is formed is going to be used as a fertilizer, which is high in nitrogenous wastes. And the water that is released after microbial treatment is environmentally safe, because it is now free from all the harmful wastes, as well as it might possibly have some harmful microbes, but the quantity or the concentration of those harmful microbes is going to be very, very less. That is why the name environmentally safe water. Microbes are also used for bioremediation of environment. Bioremediation is making an affected area better with the help of microbes. Basically, to give an example, in the lower grades, we have done this experiment where we take a glass of water, we put some soil in it, we mix it, okay? And then we use an alum to make that soil settle down. Correct. So that is a type of bioremediation. Similarly, here we are going to use microbes so as to bring about betterment in the quality of a compound. That is called as clean technology. The human being has made very fast progress in technology, and with the same speed, environmental pollution has also increased. Air pollution, soil pollution, water pollution, all of this can be controlled with the help of microbes. And this is what we learn in clean technology. Now, microbes obviously have the natural ability of decomposing. Ek hi cheez aata hai, unko decompose karo. Jo bhi hai, usko breakdown karo. They can decompose certain man-made chemicals, certain hydrocarbons are transformed into breaking down the sulfur from the fuels. Okay, so you can make use of microbes, remove sulfur, jiska overall impact kya aayega ke acid rain ka probability kam ho jayega, because sulfur mixes with the rainwater to give sulfuric acid, which comes down as acid rain. Low quality of metalloids like uranium, zinc, iron and copper leach into the environment from the mining sites. Basically, they break down, they enter the soil, and then they remain in the soil and pollute the soil for many, many years. So before leaching, you can use microbes like Theobacilli and Sulfobacilli, which convert these compounds into non-soluble ones so that they do not affect the soil. Similarly, last year we have studied that spilling of petroleum oil in the ocean can cause a lot of harms. Also, it can be because of various reasons. So instead of removing these mechanical methods, what we can do is we can take help of two bacteria, Pseudomonas species and Alcaniborax borkumensis, which can break the pyridines from these chemicals and therefore clear an oil spill. So what they do is they decompose the hydrocarbons, therefore called as the hydrocarbonoclastic bacteria. And they can produce carbon dioxide and water from it. Similarly, plastic bottles called as PET bottles, polyethylene, terephthalate, polyester. It is Alcaniborax. The corrections were given well beforehand. Polyethylene, terephthalate, polyester, PET bottles, which we use a lot on a daily basis. So, this is urban garbage ka ek bahut, bahut bada part ho jata hai. Jinko breakdown karne ke liye, we can use Vibrio and Ideonella saccharensis. What they do is they decompose these PET bottles. Similarly, rubber from garbage can also be decomposed using fungi like actinomycetes, streptomyces, nocardia, actinoplane. Sulfuric acid that comes down with the help of acid rain and from material that come out from mines can lead to erosion of metals. Statues can be destroyed. Bridges can be destroyed. Even buildings can get destroyed. So for this, we can use bacteria called Acidophyllum species and Acidobacillus ferroxidans, for which sulfuric acid is basically a source of energy. Similarly, water soluble salts of uranium, which are produced as waste during electroplating, and also it is an effluent which is released into the environment from the atomic energy plants, can be converted into insoluble salts with the help of Geobacter, so that this will prevent the uranium to mix with the groundwater and therefore help us staying to avoid uranium in water. Let's start with chapter number 8 now. Uses of stem cells. The very first is regenerative therapy, also called as cell therapy. Here, stem cells are used to replace the dead cells, that is the cells that do not function in your body. For example, in case of diabetes, there are beta cells of Langerhans, islet cells of Langerhans from pancreas, which are not producing insulin. Okay. Or they are producing insulin, but it is not enough. There is some problem with the insulin. Therefore, these cells will be replaced or can be replaced with the help of stem cells. Myocardial infarction, again, something with to deal with a heart disorder or heart disease. Alzheimer's, neuron cells or nerve cells. Parkinson's disease, again, something to do with the neurons. Then regenerative therapy can also be used for production of blood cells. So if you remember, we have done one type of disorder called as sickle cell anemia. Okay. So hum stem cells use karke regenerative therapy se proper red blood cells produce kar sakte hain. Similarly, it can also be used for treatment of thalassemia and leukemia. Then we come to organ transplantation. We all know that for organ transplantation, it is important that you have an organ donor. Okay. And obviously, it is done only and only when the other person's organ is not functioning. It is failing. Essential organs like kidney, liver can be produced with the help of stem cells and then transplanted into the patient's body. Various organs in the human body become either less efficient or they completely become functionless. I repeat, some organs in the human's body will either become less efficient or they will become completely functionless. And this can be because of various reasons. Sabse pehla aging, or there was a sudden accident, certain infections or disorders. Under such conditions, the life of that person becomes difficult or even fatality might occur. But if a person gets an organ during this stage, then it is possible that the life can be saved. When we talk about organ donation, so a donor should be present, which can lead to an organ transplant. Taking a very basic example, a person can survive with only one kidney. Okay. So let's consider there was a problem with a patient and both the kidneys failed. But my kidney, my cells of the kidney and his cells match. So there is a high chance that I can give one kidney to him and both of us can survive easily. Now, why is this going to be important? Because kidneys have a very important function, that is excretion. If waste material is not given out of the body, then there are high chances that the person might die. So one person can donate one kidney to the other person. Similarly, skin from certain parts of the body can be donated. Obviously, when transplantation is happening, various factors are going to be taken into consideration, from blood group of the donor and recipient to the age and the donor of recipient, diseases and disorders that both have. All of this is going to be taken into consideration, and only after that the transplantation operation will be done. No, it cannot be done. Why would one person donate both his kidneys to other when he is alive? However, there are certain organs that cannot be donated during the lifetime. They can only be donated after the death. For example, liver, heart, eyes, etc. This is called as posthumous donation,
which has now increased with respect to people from India as well. They voluntarily register for organ and body donation. Now let's look at a concept where biotechnology used with respect to agriculture. So talking about BT cotton. Now the word BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a bacteria which is used for production of this hybrid variety of crop. Now what is done here is the BT gene from the bacteria is taken and it is integrated with the gene of cotton plant. Now Bacillus thuringiensis produces a toxic substance which if consumed by an animal or an organism, it can lead to fatality. So here what we do is we take that gene and we insert it into the cotton plant. Because of this, what happens? The toxin which is fatal for the bollworm is now produced directly on the leaf of the plant. And when a bollworm feeds on such leaves, it is going to die because the elementary canal is going to get destroyed. So basically here we are saving the cost of pesticides as well. And also we are saving our crops from getting destroyed. Similarly, BT Brinjal can be produced where you take the gene of Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria and integrate it into the brinjal. Similarly, talking about golden rice, a gene synthesizing the vitamin A, that is beta carotene, which is also an edible color, if you remember from the last table that we saw today. It gives this golden color to the rice. Okay, so beta carotene, as I said, edible color hai. Ye vitamin A hai, jisko hum introduce kar sakte into the rice plant to give us a variety of rice called golden rice. So when you compare it with 2005, it contains 23 times more amount of beta carotene. So that is a huge amount. Herbicide tolerant plants, again something that is a very important concept and very easy one as well. Jo bhi unwanted plants hote hain, wo hamare crops ke saath kabhi kabhar grow ho jate hain. Such unwanted plants are called as weeds. So what we do is the crops that we are growing are hybrids, jinko herbicide weedicide se farak nahi padega. And this helps us with respect to spraying herbicides over the entire plantation. So herbicide tolerant plants will be the variety of crops that will be developed. And once this is done, then the weed selectively can be destroyed. Then we talk about biofertilizers. Biofertilizers ka use better ho gaya hai. Chemical fertilizers ka use kam karne lage hai. Nitrogen fixation is the basic thing that is required for a plant to have a good nutrition from the soil. So what we do is we use biofertilizers instead of these chemical fertilizers. Similarly, phosphate solubilization has also improved with the help of biofertilizers. Mainly bacteria like Rhizobium, Azotobacter, Nostoc, Anabin and Azolla plant are used as biofertilizers. Genetic improvement of plant has also become possible because of tissue culture. Basically, we can give a quality that we want to the plant. If you've ever been to the Dadar flower market, you will see that the roses that they are selling have a very good long stem and then the flower. So all of these are genetically modified plants where according to our benefit, we have made certain changes. And once that is done, it is going to be inherited into every generation after that. We'll continue from vaccines and vaccinations. Vaccine kya hota hai? So it is an antigen containing the material given to acquire either a permanent or temporary immunity. Okay, so our body is basically infected with that pathogen so that our body gets ready to fight that particular पैथोजन। ट्रेडिशनली वैक्सीन्स में क्या किया जाता था, तो वो पैथोजन को यूज करके बनाए जाते थे। इधर द कंप्लीटली किल्ड वायरस और अ पार्शियली किल्ड वायरस वॉज एडमिनिस्टर्ड और वॉज गिवन टू अस। हाउएवर ड्यू टू दिस देयर वर मेनी केसेस जिनको वो डिजीज पहले था नहीं, बट आफ्टर टेकिंग द वैक्सीन दे गॉट दैट डिजीज। सो एन ऑल्टरनेटिव मेथड वॉज यूज where artificially vaccines were produced with the help of biotechnology. What we do is we take the gene from the pathogen and that now is going to be introduced into the laboratory and made as an antigen, basically a vaccine that is taken. Now the proteins, basically jo virus ka external covering hota hai usko lekar hum banate hain protein coats. And these proteins are given to us in our body. Now, we already know what the virus is going to look like. That is our body. Our cells clearly know ke ye virus aisa dikhega, iska external covering aisa hoga. So, it always has an army of cells ready to fight against that infection. So, the proteins help in keeping the immune system active. The vaccines that are produced with the help of biotechnology are also thermostable, which means that no matter what temperature your body is, they are still going to function normally. Some artificially produced vaccines are hepatitis, vaccine of polio, etc. Aisa hi ek type hai edible vaccines jahan par पोटेटोज में एक्सपेरिमेंट्स किए जा रहे हैं। व्हाट वी डू इज वी टेक द पैथोजन, वी आइसोलेटेड जीन, वी पुट इट इनटू अ प्लांट वायरस एंड दैट प्लांट वायरस इन्फेक्ट्स द प्लांट। ओके, अब ये प्लांट वायरस ने प्लांट को इन्फेक्ट किया, मतलब प्लांट अपने बॉडी में वो एंटीबॉडीज बनाएगा बेसिकली सेल्स टू फाइट दैट इन्फेक्शन। इफ यू ईट दोज फ्रूट्स और दोज वेजिटेबल्स in the raw form, those antibodies enter your body and therefore you are now capable of fighting against that infection. Such potatoes are called as transgenic potatoes. ये किसके अगेंस्ट काम करेंगे, तो विब्रिया कोलेरे, एस्टेरिशिया कोलेरे, which are responsible for many diseases. बस एक चीज है that they have to be eaten in the raw form. Biotechnology is also used for production of hormones like insulin, somatotropin, blood clotting factors, etc. ये भी small size proteins ही हैं, which are used in viral disease का treatments. Then there are interferons, as I said, जो blood में produce होते हैं. Biotechnology use करके हम transgenic E. coli भी produce कर सकते हैं, जो हमें ये interferon small साइज प्रोटीन्स बनाने में हेल्प करें। जीन थेरेपी, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट इट, इज हेल्पफुल टू ट्रीट जेनेटिक डिसऑर्डर्स इन द सोमैटिक सेल्स। आई होप यू रिमेंबर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड लेक्चर व्हाट सोमैटिक सेल्स आर। एनी सेल अदर देन द रिप्रोडक्टिव सेल आर कॉल्ड एज सोमैटिक सेल्स। Phenyl ketonuria PKU arises due to a genetic change in the hepatocyte, that is the cells of the liver. It has now become possible to treat it with gene therapy. और इसी चीज को हम बोलते हैं somatic cell gene therapy. Coming to the most important concept of the chapter, cloning. Cloning की हम बात करें तो क्या होता है? It is basically producing a replica, exact replica of an organism. First type of cloning is reproductive cloning, जहां पर हम fusion करेंगे of two gamete cells, but nucleus will be from the somatic cell and you will take the ovum, that is the female reproductive cell, and now a new cell that is directly the zygote will be formed. So iska wajah se kya hua ke sperm ka zarurat hi nahi pada.
process of cloning Dolly was a cell was collected from the mammary gland of female Finn Dorset sheep, and the ovum was produced from the Scottish blackface. अभी you might be confused कि sir अगर ovum Scottish blackface से लिया है तो जो उसका next generation है वो blackface जैसा दिखना चाहिए, which is correct. But what happens is the egg cell is enucleated. That is the nucleus of the egg cell is removed. तो उसका जो information था पूरा का पूरा वो तो चला गया. हम क्या करते हैं उसके जगह दूसरे ऑर्गेनिज्म दूसरे टाइप के शीप में से हमने लिया एक सोमैटिक सेल जिसमें 46 क्रोमोसोम्स हैं. एग्जांपल गिविंग एन एग्जांपल के उसमें पूरे 2n नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स हैं, वो क्रोमोसोम को हमने डाल दिया इनटू द ओवम. सो नाउ इट इज अ जायगोट क्योंकि हमारे दो गैमेट सेल्स n प्लस n मिलकर 2n बनाते हैं. यहां पर हमने डायरेक्ट ओवम को 2n बना दिया. सो इट इज नाउ अ जायगोट. When it grows, it is going to look like the organism from which the nucleus was taken and not the ovum. So egg was later implanted into the blackface Eve, and after normal development, Dolly was born. Kiske jaise dikhti thi Dolly? So even though it was given birth by Scottish blackface, it was identical to the Finn Dorset sheep from which the somatic cell or from which the nucleus was taken. Other cloning is therapeutic cloning, where by the union of somatic cell nucleus with the egg cell, you can produce stem cells in the laboratory. Similarly, you can produce genes जिससे हम genetic disorders को treat करने का try कर सकते हैं. What are the possibilities that can happen? So you can control the inheritance of hereditary diseases. However, the cloning is illegal and human cloning is an opposition. Hopefully in years to come, it gets possible.